The views expressed on the following program are designed to amplify those of the speaker and are not necessarily those of KAAM, KNSN, DJRD Broadcasting, Crawford Media Group, or its sponsors.
Hello, everybody!
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I've got the month of May.
Here's what's coming up on today's experience. It's Dr. Dave's Devotional Diamonds of the Day, also known as DDDDDs, where my daily devotions become some of our spiritual reflections. Sound effects placed throughout the show which have nothing to do with life, but the Bible teaches there's a time to laugh. Ecclesiastes 3:4. The review of the goofy news which proves Jesus is coming back sooner than you think. And if you're a Bible-believing, born-again Christian, you're like, yes! Life lessons for our faith that we could actually use probably won't if we sit on our blessed assurance. Humor that will force you to think, why does this guy have a radio show? Because I want to. Oh, okay. Also, Bible trivia for fake and yet somehow real cool prizes, your phone calls, and more. Welcome to the David Spoon Experience, local, national, and heavenly talk. My name is Dr. David Spoon, and I will be your host for the next 5,400,000 milliseconds. Get ready for one of the more bizarre experiences on live radio. Here is the key to the show. We don't know what we're doing. There you go. We have no idea what's going to happen, and we don't care. But for the next few minutes, I want to talk love with you. So here we go. We're asking questions about living life as a Christian. That thingy right there. And here I am again, on a Thursday again, doing it again, seeing if people will respond again. Are we expecting more in 2024? Are you expecting a poke in the eye with a sharp stick? Or are you expecting great things are coming? Which one are you looking at? Which one are you anticipating? Where is your faith? Where is my faith in all of our circumstances and situations? Do we truly trust in the goodness of God? Ooh. It's very simple. Very, very simple. If you have an opinion, a comment, a thought, or a question on that, please don't let it die of loneliness. We want you to be able to reach out to us. It's simple to do. You call 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. When you call 972-445-0770, you'll end up talking to Jammin' Jacob. Talking to Jammin' Jacob is like spending time relaxing and chillaxing.
Thank you, David. Happy Thursday.
Happy Thursday to you, my friend. All is well, I assume. Do you have to work this weekend, by the way? Are you working this weekend?
No, I'm off this weekend.
Oh, well, congratulations. That's very nice. I'm very happy for you.
Thank you. Have a couple days off. It's nice.
That is nice to get. All right, folks, it's simple. You can either call us, that's simple, or you can text us. So right now, if you're in San Diego, it's 11:35. If you're in Denver, it's 12:35. If you're in Dallas, it's 1:35. If you're in Detroit, it's 2:35. If you're underneath the ocean, what are you doing underneath the ocean listening to a radio show? What is wrong with you?
Maybe they're in a submarine.
We all live in a yellow submarine. All right. Anyway, bottom line is simply this. You can reach out and text us 214-210-8483. That's 214-210-8483. Semi-professional voice coming now.
214-210-8483.
There you go. Additionally, you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org, for as long as my Chromebook continues to last. david@hemustincrease.org. He must increase all one thing. hemustincrease.org, because we're a nonprofit entity. So you can reach out to us by calling 972-445-0770, texting 214-210-8483, or emailing david@hemustincrease.org. Why would you do that? Very simple. Maybe you've got a praise report. Praise reports are cool. Why are they cool? First, they honor God. Second, they bless people who hear it. Third, they reinforce it in your own life. Maybe you've got a prayer request. We're going to be praying for two people in just a minute who have very serious things going on in their lives, and we're going to be praying for them. I'm going to ask you to combine your faith. You think, well, what happens? You pray. You ask God to enter the situation, to take control. You yield your authority, your power, your control into His hands. And there is nothing better than having any and every situation in the palm of the Lord God Almighty. He's the King of the universe. I think He can handle your situation. That's what I'm going to go with. So we're going to pray for that as well. Maybe you've got something you want to bring up. Maybe it's something the Lord has shown you. Maybe you've got something that He revealed to you. Maybe you just want to share a word of encouragement. All of that is good. We don't mind observations, even if they're political. We're just more focused on encouraging one another. We're not taking anything away from any other show. We never do that. We think that's a bad idea. Our mindset is simply this. During this show, we're going to do our best to encourage one another in the faith and with one another, loving one another, and being a representative of Jesus Christ as we see the day of the return of Jesus Christ getting closer and closer. And it is much closer now than ever before, right? That's an absolute truth. So what we are going to do is we're going to pray for two people. These are two people that are connected to some of the people in the radio audience. First person we're going to pray for is Cynthia. Cynthia has cancer, and we're going to be praying for Cynthia. She is has kind of a terminal disease, a friend of Noelle's. We're going to be praying for her. Plus, we're going to pray for Shannon, who is a worker or kind of a steward with our very own Joy Ann and Cordelia. And so we're going to be praying for cancer along for Shannon as well. And we're asking the Lord, and you're thinking, well, cancer, wow, that's huge. Well, I don't have the power to cure cancer, but Jesus does. And what do we know for a fact? Well, Rosalind's doing pretty good. We're pretty happy about that. We've been praying for her. And September's doing fantastic, and we've been praying for her. And so we're just going to keep praying and believing because that's the way we approach it. Let's go to the Father in the name of the Son with help from the Holy Spirit. Let's do it. Father, we come before You right now. We thank You. We praise You. We worship You. We acknowledge You first and foremost. First, I thank my God. That's what it says in Romans, Lord, and that's what we do first. Thank You for everything. Even the things, Lord, we don't get, we know You're working them in such a way so they will produce something that's good. That's the merciful, gracious hand that You use to deal with us. And we are forever in Your debt and forever appreciative. So we lift up both Shannon and Cynthia, who are struggling with things that are past us. It's in Your realm. You're the one that can resurrect the body from the dead. We're asking You to manifest Your power in their bodies, in their lives. We're asking You, in the name of Jesus, to bring healing into their bodies. We've seen it happen to people that we've prayed for on the show. We're going to keep praying and asking and pursuing You. And we're asking You to manifest that into Cynthia and into Shannon's life, that they can be free from disease, free from cancer. We don't care if it makes sense. What we care about is that they get touched by You. We pray this. We ask the power of the Holy Spirit would fall upon them and heal them. And we pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. And all the people in the radio audience are saying amen and amen. Right into the Word of God we are going. We are at some very, very intense portions of Scripture. We are in the book of Jude, Jesus' brother. We are at verse 10, and this is, let's say it's a little less than pretty and what we're going to get involved with, but it is what the Word is, and we don't do it to tickle itching ears. We do it to communicate the truth, and we want to communicate the entire counsel to the Lord, of the Lord, from the Lord, to the Lord, towards us from the Lord. Said that wrong. All right. Jude, verse 10. These men, making reference to the people that, and I'll back it up, that even Michael, the archangel Michael, when he disputed with the devil over the body of Moses, did not presume to bring slanderous charges against the Lord, but simply said, the Lord rebuke you. So what Jude is talking about is these people that have no problem rejecting authority and slandering glorious beings, and these people are just kind of losing their mindsets. But this is what he says in verse 10. These men, however, slander what they do not understand. And like irrational animals, they will be destroyed by the things they do instinctively. Let me say this real quickly about that. It's very, very powerful. These people are slandering things they don't understand. Have you ever noticed when people slander Christians, they don't know what's going on. You know they don't know about the love of Jesus. You know that they've turned their hearts away, and they're very brutal, and they're mean, and they're almost like animalistic with no rationality, and it's like it's terrible. And so this behavior, verse 10, discusses individuals who defile what they do not comprehend, like biblical truth. They behave like irrational animals. It's remarkable that humans, created in the image and the likeness of God, can exhibit such behavior. We're not referring to pets or other appealing creatures, but to irrational animals that have been acting radically off mark, off nature. The scripture in Jude is unequivocal. There's no room in this whatsoever. Here's what Jude says. Woe unto them. It ain't going to go good. And then they say this, and this is where it's so powerful. They have traveled in the path of Cain. They have rushed headlong into the error of Balaam. They have perished in Korah's rebellion. Wow. What is that all about? Those are three distinct people. And what Jude is saying is these people who are acting irrational, anti-faith, speaking of things they do not understand, slandering glorious beings, are following three pathways. What are those pathways, Dave? Well, the first one is they're traveling in the pathway of Cain. What do we know from our studies in Genesis? Cain let sin overwhelm him and committed murder. These people commit murder in their hearts and in actualities, and they are dark. And the rationale is, I feel like I'm entitled, therefore I'm entitled to kill. And it's like, woe unto them. They've traveled in the way of Cain, who's a murderer. Then, and watch this, this is really powerful, they recklessly embrace the error of Balaam. What does that mean? What are you talking about, Dave? Well, Balaam was hired to curse the people of God. And these people are the same people that curse Christians. They curse the people of God. They hate them. They despise them. They mock them. Again, I'm just going to reiterate what Jude said. I didn't say it. Jude said it. Woe unto them. It is not going to go well. And so Balaam was hired to curse the people of God, and he couldn't do it, because God wouldn't let him. And he ultimately speaks the blessing upon the people of God, and that's often what happens is people come against the people of God, the children of God, the apple of God's eye, the people who are of genuine faith in Christ, the people who are chosen, like the Jewish people from the Old Testament, just very simple, and that the two, the Gentile and the Jew, in the New Testament becomes one. They become Christian. We talked about that a long, long time ago, but we'll just get into this. These bad people are trying to curse, destroy, kill. Okay, so I have a question for you. What's going on in society right now where people are trying to destroy, kill, or curse Christians and Jewish people? Where's that going on? Get it? I mean, it's not even that hard to cop. Oh my goodness, that's taking place right now on our campuses. That's right. No, it's so peaceful that they beat people up. Oh, okay. So they're going after the reckless error of Balaam. Then, wait. This even gets worse. Then they've perished in Korah's rebellion. And what was the rebellion of this guy? This guy was opposed to Moses. He was involved in opposing God's chosen people and attempted to lead people astray. So that you can know how serious God is about this, this was the people that were there when Moses said, you're going to die by a way that's never been done before, and the earth opened up and swallowed them. This is how serious it is to the Lord. In every instance, in the instance of Cain, where it's murder and death and just anger that's uncontrolled. In the way of Balaam, it's all about cursing and making these people horrid and making their lives miserable or making being as mean as they can be. Or Korah's rebellion, trying to literally lead people away from what God is trying to teach people. And Jude's done. There's no pulling punches here. If you got itching ears, you're turning this off. Here's the bottom line. Those people are going to get it from God, period. And you know what? I don't want to be the one that judges them. I could never judge them justly. You could never judge them justly. People keep saying, well, we should do this and we should do this. You know what? God is going to give the right, perfect judgment for those that are coming against his people. That's what's going to happen. And it's like, I don't want to touch that. That's all in the Lord's hands. Only the Lord has the ability to judge at that level. And it's like, okie dokie, you just do whatever, Lord. We just know your ways are just and true, and we just ask you to protect your people. We ask you to keep us away from people that want to murder us, that are so angry in us, they want us to die. We ask you to keep us away from people that want to curse us. They just hate us so much because we love you. And we ask you to help keep us away from these people that are trying to lead your kids in the wrong direction in rebellion against your truths and your ways. Just keep us from these people, Lord. And it's woe unto them, and Lord, you handle it, and it's all good for us. We entrust ourselves into your hands. You are the righteous judge. Protect your kids. That's what we pray. Okay? All right. Take a deep breath. Don't tell me that wasn't intense. It has nothing to do with camping. It was just intense, okay? All right, here we go. That's right, it was a joke. Here you go. Here's your first trivia question. Who baptized Jesus? There it is. Who baptized Jesus? If you think you know the answer, 972-445-0770. That's 972-445-0770. You can also text 214-210-8483. That's 214-210-8483. Or you can send an email, david@hemustincrease.org. That's david@hemustincrease.org. Going to send you up to the website as we often do. In this particular place, here's what I want you to know about what's on the website. Of course, there's access to a multitude of hours of podcasts. That's number one. Number two, there's a place to put your information if you want prayer requests or if you want to offer up a praise report. Okay, that's number two. Got that. There is access to the new book that we have, and if you can't afford the book, the ministry will pay for it. We have no problems doing that. Well, on top of that, no, we also have a place to give. And if you want to give, that's great. If you can't give, don't worry. No stressy. Okay? How do I say that? How do I say it? When Bert goes outside, we say no barky. No barky. Okay? Here's what I'm saying to you. No stressy. No stressy. No stressing. Just relax. If you can't give or you can't do it, no problem. Still go to the website. Still get stuff from it. Still enjoy it. Still get something from it. Don't feel weird about it or guilty or anything like that. The Lord knows what's going on. We know what's going on. We've all been in the same place. Let's do it right, okay? Let's have a right spirit about it. If you can give, great. If the Lord puts it on your heart, fantastic. Here's our scripture for giving, Proverbs 3:9. Honor the Lord with your wealth and with the first fruits of all your produce, which means we're supposed to honor him with that which we have. We are, in fact, stewards of that which he gives us. Check it all out on the website. HeMustIncrease.org.
Prayer request?
HeMustIncrease.org.
Praise report?
HeMustIncrease.org.
Looking to give to this ministry?
HeMustIncrease.org.
Confused by what's happening right now?
HeMustIncrease.org.
HeMustIncrease.org.
Gotta rehearse my song. Whoa! Oh, Yeah, it's kind of pretty before it gets started, ain't it? Oh, Frogamony Gordon, he didn't ride Crambo.
They're going to haul us away. I'm just telling you right now. I just can guarantee you. We're going to get a knock on the door going, boys, come here.
Right, right.
That was just so funny. I have nothing else to say. All right, we do have somebody ready to answer the trivia question. Let's send them on through. Knock, knock. This is David. Who am I talking to?
This is a scuba diver.
What, you went from the moon to scuba diving? Holy moly, that's a lot of traveling.
Today is a scuba diving day, so I'm in the dock. Earlier you were saying, what are you doing underneath the water? So that's what I'm doing.
You're scuba diving, see? You're just checking out all the planet's cool stuff underneath, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Under the sea.
Oh, don't you start singing. All right, here we go. Let me set up the trivia question. You can answer it. And I know it's not much of a challenge, but we need to get it rolling. Who baptized Jesus?
Dr. Jeffers. Robert Jeffers, because he's the first Baptist.
Oh, you're so good. You're so good. Who's the first Baptist? What's his name?
John
the Baptist! Dr. Robert Jeffers, that's great. If he heard that, he would just be cracking up. That's a great line. Anyway, how are you doing, bro?
I'm doing happy and blessed.
Happy and blessed. That's one of the first times you said it just like that. That is a great thing to hear. And we just praise the Lord that you are happy and blessed and that the Lord covers you in all things that you're not sure about, that he will handle for you, and that you don't have to worry or fret because he has your back. Okay.
Hey, David, on a serious note, I'm going to share something. Like earlier, you were praying for Cynthia and Sharon, I believe, or Shannon.
Shannon, that's right, yeah. Cynthia and Shannon.
And Lord just reminded me when I was a young man, like my father shared a testimony of one lady that she had a cancer, and she clinged to the verse like, by his stripe, I'm healed. And she was healed. And then maybe 10 years ago, or less than 10 years ago, I met somebody. They also pray against cancer, and they use this scripture. I believe it's Matthew 15:13, that whatever my father hasn't planted, he will yank it out or he will uproot it. So I just want to pray in a testimony, because if God healed those two persons, he would heal Cynthia and Shannon as well, because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So I'm just claiming for my sister that they are healed, because our God is a good God, and he's an awesome God.
Amen. Amen. And that reference is excellent reference. Matthew 15:13. He answered, every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. That is that reference point. Excellent reference point.
Yeah, God never plants a cancer to his children. So
yes.
Yeah.
All right, my brother. Do you want to say a prayer?
You just read a Jude like the Lord rebukes that cancer.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. So why don't you pray? Why don't you say a quick prayer for them?
Oh yes, Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, that you are an awesome Heavenly Father, and Lord, I bring your children, Cynthia and Shannon, before your throne of grace, and I ask you to touch them with your healing hand, and I speak your name, Jehovah Rapha, over them, because by your stripe they are healed. In Jesus' name I say this prayer. Amen and amen.
Amen. That is very, very powerful. Very good share on that testimony. So that was really good to hear that, and I'm glad you're praying. And we want everybody in the audience doing exactly what Sam said. Be praying for everybody. Be praying for these people. Be praying for Cynthia. Be praying for Shannon. We want the Lord to touch them. Why? Because we then get to share in the rejoicing with our sisters in the Lord. How cool is that? It's like a party. That's what you want. Excellent job, brother.
Thank you, sir.
All right. God bless you.
Have a blessed day. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye-bye. All right. And so that's a big part of what we do. So I know some people are newer to the show and you're like going, well, that's just, you know, weird stuff. Yep. Here, I'll make it super easy for you. You betcha. That's, it is kind of goofy. And then you have to think about how the show goes, because we know we have kind of a structure, but we're just trying to follow the best we can. So you just heard this massively intense teaching from Jude about these really bad people, and then we're talking about praying and healing. And well, that's the Christian walk. It's a little bit of everything, isn't it? Jesus said, I have come that they might have life and life more abundant. So some people interpret that as just really good stuff. It's like, that's not what it says. It says life and life more abundant. You're more alive. You have an abundance of life. And life consists of many different things. The great part about life in the kingdom of God is it consists of partnership with God. And so whatever you're going through, whatever this situation is, whatever this struggle is, whatever this frustration is, if you're doing it in partnership with God, you're already ahead. You're already winning, so to speak. But it's abundant life in Him, not by yourself or for yourself. Get that? Okay. All right, so if you are in San Diego, or if you are in Denver, or you might be in Detroit, hey, you can just go to HeMustIncrease.org and click on the Listen Live button. That's all that takes. If you are in Dallas, listening on the radio, our app, or the KAAM app, just hang out. Short break. We'll be back. Don't go anywhere.
This KAAM radio show with your very own David Spoon is not a business, but a nonprofit ministry first and foremost committed to sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ and strategically equipping the saints. Our mission is to educate, encourage, and entertain Christian believers, the hurting, and those not yet believers who need biblical truths. To continue our radio ministry and message of truth, we need many of our faithful listeners to support us, as well as ministry partners who might wish to sponsor the He Must Increase ministry. By giving, you wonderfully facilitate our priorities of assertively teaching the Word of God, and you get nothing in return. No quid pro quo. Nothing but a receipt at the end of the year indicating you gave to us, since your donation is 100% tax deductible. Remember that it says in Corinthians that whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Or in Proverbs, where it teaches that a generous person will prosper, whoever refreshes others will be refreshed. But if you cannot give, no problem. Continue to enjoy and learn and give however you see fit whenever you can. To support us, go to HeMustIncrease.org. That's HeMustIncrease.org. Such support is terribly appreciated, knowing it enables our beloved David Spoon to give to all of us his time, energy, like so few can. Right here on KAAM.
What is the David Spoon Experience?
Now, I want to pull this out of Jude. Jude only has one chapter. Jude is the letter before the book of Revelation. Revelation, singular. It's the last letter before the book of Revelation. And this is what it says in verses 17 through 19. I want you to listen to this, and then I want you to think about today, all the stuff that's going on. I'm not going to go overly political. I want you just to consider the landscaping that we're all living in right now, the landscape that we're, of society. It says this, "But you must remember, beloved, that the predictions of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, they said to you, in the last times there will be scoffers following their own ungodly passions. It is these who cause divisions, worldly people devoid of the Holy Spirit." Now listen to that. This is a prophecy that is being brought up by Jude, who is a brother to Jesus, won't even identify himself that way, brother to James, who was in charge of the church after the James of Peter, James, John died in Acts 12. In Acts 15, the other James kind of ascends to the position of power, so to speak. And he's not in charge of everybody. He's just kind of leading the show, and like Peter did in the early church. And this is Jude, his brother, and the brother of Jesus. And he's telling you got to remember what the apostles said. The apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. He's so humble when he writes that.